It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, you are deploying an application to a Kubernetes cluster that requires a username and password to connect to another service. When you deploy the application, you want to ensure that the credentials are used securely in multiple environments with minimal code changes. What should you do? Key parts of the question, of course, you're using a Kubernetes cluster. There are a couple of services that are trying to communicate with each other. And this service requires that you provide it a username password. So we have to have some way to get that username and password into that running service. But of course, we do not want these credentials to be exposed to anybody. It should be saved securely. And we should have the same approach even when you're working in multiple environments. Let us say testing, staging, and production. And we should be able to do this with very minimal code changes. If you know Kubernetes, the answer to this is straightforward, but let's look at each of the options and eliminate the ones that are not right and learn through that process. Option A suggests that we bundle the credentials with the code inside the container and secure the container registry. But when you have code checked in and you have the credentials along with that code, it means essentially everybody who's got access to the code repository can now see the username passwords. That is not acceptable. Ideally, very few people in the team who've got access to the production systems should have access to these credentials. So checking in code is not an approach at all. Of course, since we're going to have multiple environments, we might even have to have multiple check-ins, one for the testing environment, one for staging, one for production. Either ways, this is not a good approach, and therefore we can easily eliminate option A. Option B suggests that we leverage a CI/CD pipeline to update the variables at build time and inject them into a templated Kubernetes application manifest. What is an application manifest for Kubernetes? They are plain text YAML files. If they are plain text, these credentials are going to be exposed again. So anything plain text is ruled out as an option. It is also the case that typically CI/CD pipelines are today checked in. How you do the build, how you do the integration, how you do the deployment. There are scripts that are written to do this steps. And if you have got to insert the username password for each of them, typically those things are also going to be checked in, which means visible to a large number of people. Therefore, this also should not be allowed. And of course, if you're having multiple environments, we'll have to have a build for testing, another one for staging, another one for production, and we're going to have to modify the script files for each of them, which is not a good approach again, because we want minimal code changes. So option C is also eliminated. Option D suggests that we store the credentials as a Kubernetes config map and let the application access it via environment variables at runtime. This is possible. However, config maps are also saved as plain text. And this obviously exposes the credentials, and therefore this is not the right option. Option B suggests that we store the credentials as a Kubernetes secret and let the application access via environment variables at runtime. So similar approach as option D, except instead of a config map, we are using a secret. And this is the recommended approach when working with Kubernetes. When saved as a secret, it encodes it using Base64 and is obfuscated. Therefore, anybody who's got access even to the production systems but do not know the credentials with access of that elsewhere will not be able to figure out what the secrets are, in which in this case, which is the username and password. So this is a recommended way to use a Kubernetes secret. Now, this is a very straightforward question, but the key thing that we take away from this is that for this exam, you absolutely need to understand Kubernetes. So please go to the labs, please go study. There are a lot of books and documentation, and make yourself at least at an intermediate level when it comes to Kubernetes. If you thought that content was great, you absolutely must check out all our new upcoming content. So subscribe right away.